हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद द यूनिट सोसाइटल इम्पैक्ट्स पार्ट वन। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द न्यू टॉपिक। द टॉपिक इज नेट एटिकेट्स, और वी कैन से ऑनलाइन कम्युनिकेशन एटिकेट्स। सो ऑल ऑफ यू आर अवेयर विद द टर्म एटिकेट्स। सो एटिकेट्स इज अ कोड ऑफ पोलाइट बिहेवियर इन सोसाइटी। इन द सेम मैनर नेट एटिकेट्स और ऑनलाइन कम्युनिकेशन एटिकेट्स इज रेफर्स टू द कोड ऑफ पोलाइट बिहेवियर दैट वी हैव टू फॉलो व्हाइल वी आर ऑनलाइन और व्हाइल वी आर यूजिंग द इंटरनेट। सो द बिहेवियर दैट वी हैव टू फॉलो व्हाइल वी आर यूजिंग द इंटरनेट और व्हाइल वी आर ऑनलाइन, दैट टाइप ऑफ एटिकेट्स आर नोन एज द नेट एटिकेट्स। So, net etiquette is short for internet etiquette. We can say it internet etiquettes also, or we can say it online communication etiquettes. It is just like etiquettes in normal life, normal human being life. What roles plays the etiquettes? In the same manner, the same role is played by the net etiquettes in the online communication. It includes several aspects of internet. Okay, so this type of net etiquettes can be seen anywhere, while we are using the social media, while we are using the email facilities or online chatting, websites, while we are visiting any website. So every online activities is include the net etiquettes. Okay, so in your net etiquettes we can see in all type of activities or all types of aspects that we follow during the online. So now after that we will continue that the new topic. That topic is what net etiquettes or communication etiquettes we have to follow or we don't have to follow. So first of all we will discuss that which etiquettes we have to follow. First of all, the messages and the post we have to keep in brief form so that no one can get boredom while reading the messages or viewing the post. So we have to keep in the summarized form. Next, protect personal information. While we are online, while we are involving the online activities, then we have to keep our personal information in a protective manner. Obey copyright laws, the rules and regulations that is decided by the online communities, we have to follow that. We have to help others while we are online. If any person is any problem in cyber problem, we have to help others. We have to respect each other's privacy. Don't only not respect or not care about our privacy, we have to respect other people's privacy. We don't have the right to break the privacy of any person. Verify facts before reposting. If we post any facts or any post or any messages, firstly we have to verify before posting. Check messages and respond properly. If we are in the group or if we are in the any social media or any individual group, then we have to check the messages on the regular basis and we have to respond quickly regarding that messages. Thank other who help you online. We have to thankful to the person who help us, and we have to show good sportsmanship when playing online games. While we are using the online games facility, then we have to show the good sportsman to our partners. In the same manner, now we will discuss what we don't have to follow while we are online. So firstly, we have to save from posting offensive type of comment that can hurt to any other person. So such type of comments we have not posted. Post private or embarrassing images comment. We don't post the private or embarrassing images that are private images of our family and friends. We don't have to post such type of images इन द सोशल मीडिया, एक्सप्रेस ऑफेंसिव ओपिनियंस. वी डोंट हैव टू एक्सप्रेस एनी टाइप ऑफ ऑफेंसिव ओपिनियंस इन द सोशल मीडिया. एक्सक्लूड पीपल और टॉक बिहाइंड देयर बैक्स. इफ वी आर इन द एनी सोशल मीडिया ग्रुप, देन इफ वी हैव इंक्लूडेड एनी पर्सन, सो विदाउट एनी प्रूफ वी डोंट हैव टू एक्सक्लूड द पीपल ऑन आर पर्सनल प्रॉब्लम्स. ओके, सो एंड नाउ नेक्स्ट इज स्टिक टू द टॉपिक. इफ वी आर इन द एनी ग्रुप, देन वी हैव टू डिस्कस ऑन द टॉपिक दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग बाय एवरी वन. वी हैव टू स्टिक एंड डोंट वी हैव टू स्टिक टू दैट टॉपिक. Generally, we have to talk on that topic, but don't we have to stick on the, or don't become the rigid on the topic. Spam others by sending large amounts of unsolicited emails. There is no need to sending bulk mails to any other else. So these are the do's and don'ts that we have to follow or don't follow during the online. Now, after that, students, we will discuss the data protection. All of you know that data is the most sensitive part of any organization. So the protection of data is the very most important term in nowadays. Data protection, it refers to the rules and regulations, and we can say it refers to the practices and safeguard and the binding rules put in place to protect our personal information. So the rules and regulation that is used to protect our personal information, that's known as the data protection. In short, we should be able to decide whether or not we want to share some information, who has access to it, for how long, for what reason, and be able to modify some of this information. So students, data protection is the very most important topic of nowadays. So if data is a sensitive part of any organization, so the protection of data also becomes the important. So the protection of data means which practices, which rules and regulations we have to follow to make our data protect from the hacking of our data or for the misusing of our data. So here we will discuss what are the consequences of unprotected data or data breaches. So it is very necessary to protect our data, and what are the consequences and what are the result of the unprotected data. If we not protect our data, then what results we have to face. So we can suffer from security attack, we can suffer from any cyber attack because we have not protected our data. So anybody can easily attack on our data. He or she can hack our data, or he or she can misuse our sensitive data. So it is very necessary to protect our data. Physical data loss, we can lose that data if any virus can attack on our PC, or if any hacker can attack on our sensitive data, then we can lose our data. Hit with a virus, we can suffer from the virus, so we have to protect our data to save us from the virus infection of our systems. Targeted by hackers, our sensitive data can be targeted by the any hacker or cracker. We can suffer from the distributed denial of services, DDoS. It's a type of cyber attack. So if we will not protect our data, we can targeted by the DDoS. So in this type of attack, even if we have the resources, even if we have the memory space in our system, but except that system is refused to us because we are suffer from the distributed denial of services attack. We can loss of money because the digital data is the very sensitive part of any organization. All informations are secured in the form of the digital data. So in indirect manner, we can loss of money if we will not protect our digital data. इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी एट रिस्क. इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी मीन्स द डिजिटल प्रॉपर्टी. ओके, सो इन द करेंट टाइम आर properties becomes intellectual properties because our whole property is in the data, because our data is summarized into the our whole property is summarized into the digital data. Digital data collect the all informations of our such type of any financial information. So by using the intellectual property, we can face the risk, damage, downtime. We our server can be attacked, or our servers can be targeted by the hackers or crackers. So we have to follow the damages also. So these are the results of the unprotected data. If we don't protect our data, then we have to follow such types of results. So here we will discuss how we can protect our personal data. So first of all, we have to save our data. We have to protect our data by using the encryption technique. All of you know that what is the encryption? Encryption is a technique in which we encoded our data into the unreadable format, that is not readable by the human being. In the encryption technique, we have to encoded our data while we are sending our important data from one system to another system. Then we have to send our data in the encrypted format, and on the destination PC we have to apply the decryption technique to convert the encrypted data. So we have to use the encryption technique to protect our data. Now after that, we have to use the keep password privates. We have to store our data by using the, we have to save our data by using the strong password technique, and we have to keep that password private. We don't have to share that password with the unauthorized people. Don't overshare on social networking site. We don't have to share our very personal information on the social networking sites. Use security software. We have to use the antivirus softwares in our systems to protect our data. And after installing the, or after downloading the antivirus software, we have to regularly updates on that softwares. We have to avoid phishing emails. We don't have to open the emails if we if that emails come from the unknown IDs. Be wise about Wi-Fi. If we are using the wireless fidelity network, then we don't have to transfer our sensitive personal informations. Be alert to impersonators. We have to alert that somebody is not showing our password when we are inserting passwords in our system. Safely dispose of the personal information. If we are using the systems in the cyber cafe, then we have to safely log out our from mail IDs or any other social media ID we are using on the cyber cafe. Then we have to safely log out, and we have to also delete the history from the browsers if we are logging, or if we are using the cyber cafe, or if we are using any other person's system, then we have to safely log out or safely delete the history of the browsers. Thank you and have a nice day.